Good evening, doctors.
This is my second presentation. Last Saturday I did it in public health center for 8 persons and 22 empty chairs. I'm happy. Now at least the hall is full. And when I presented the match referee, Dr. Chandrasekhar said, "You have spoken for 37 minutes, so make it Bahubali 1, Bahubali 2. So that's why I put bedside psychiatry 1. And the bedside psychiatry 2 may come next month or maybe next year, depending on the slot given by the IMA CME coordinators. Because it's very difficult to get a slot in IMA Kodambakam branch. It's as good as getting a seat in MLA or MP. Now, my bedside psychiatry, I thank sincerely the public health center where I worked for 35 years and voluntary health services for 35 years as an honorary doctor. I thank my teachers. I thank especially IMA Kodambakam branch. What to talk, what not to talk, how much to talk, the time frame, every time Dr. Chandrasekhar raises the bar. When I talk for 18 minutes, he'll say 17 minutes and 50 seconds. So I practiced in the morning, my wife said, "You have spoken only for 9 minutes. I really do not know where to go about it. So I am only a clinician, let me be very honest, I'm only a clinician. I'm a mental health professional. I've been mentored by Dr. Vijay Kumar and Lakshmi Vijay Kumar, two doyens in the field of psychiatry. Both of them, I'm proud to say that our members. Let me start with the first slide, please. Now this is being prepared by my son. So put it as executive summary. And I'm going to cover like this: introduction, schizophrenia, depression, and take-home message. My introduction, I'm very happy that IMA Kodambakam branch is able to celebrate the mental health month. We are celebrating it. And World Mental Health is observed on 10th. So every year we give a theme. Today, this year, young people and mental health in a challenging world is the theme for this year. So we are conducting all over Tamil Nadu, all over India, to create an awareness of mental health. Now half of all mental illness begins by the age of 14. In terms of the burden of the disease among adolescents, depression is the third leading cause. I'll come back to it once I talk about depression. Suicide is the second leading cause of death among 15 to 29 year olds. Harmful use of alcohol and illicit drugs among adolescents is a major issue in many countries and can lead to risky behaviors such as unsafe sex and dangerous living. Now, the important disease which is common among all the mental illness is schizophrenia. The moment you say he's a schizophrenic, people think about 40 years, that's all, his life is gone. I request all of you to see a movie called Beautiful Mind, which is won Oscar awards, 4 Oscar awards. It's about a life history of a Nobel laureate. It's called John Nash. 4 years back, he died in a car accident along with his wife. The duration, the nature, the course of the illness, and the prognosis of the illness, how treatment has effectively enforced by his wife to get a Nobel Prize. You must see, it's only 90 minutes. Now, the incidence is 15 per 1 lakh population. 1.4:1 is the male to female ratio. Homicide and suicide are risk factors. You would have seen in Institute of Mental Health, there will be a separate cell for those people who have killed their wife or who killed their brothers or sisters. They will be in a jail-like thing. Now, that is for homicide. Now, usually, as a physician, you do a physical examination. Likewise, before physical examination, detailed history is very important in all illnesses. But in psychiatry, sometimes it's very difficult to take a history if he's a violent patient. I'll come back to that, what has happened to me. Now, general observation, many of our busy OP psychiatry practice, where we see around 40 patients in voluntary health service, the moment he enters the room, he'll be able to make the diagnosis. Professor Balan used to say, one of our senior most psychiatrists, making a diagnosis in mental illness takes only 2 minutes, but treating a mental illness takes 2 years, sometimes 20 years, sometimes lifelong. Now, the appearance is very important in schizophrenia. He'll be shabby, unshaven face, he will be very dirty, sometimes he'll be wearing 3-4 clothes. Before the advent of handset, they used to have a cotton plugs all the time, 365 days. These are all indicators. And also they used to have a dark colored glasses, you know, cooling glass like M.G. Ramachandran, all the time, even in the night. Now, that appearance gives you a clue that he's may be a schizophrenic. Now speech, it will be irrelevant. If you talk to him for half an hour, you will not understand what he has spoken. You keep on talking to him, he will be jumping from one topic to another topic. That's called woolly talk, and you will not be able to understand anything. Then behavior, certain peculiar behaviors will be seen. While talking to him, he will be scratching his head, he will be making some odd movements. The moment he enters a room, he will do like this, no? He will do like this, he won't cross it immediately. All these abnormal movements will give you a clue. Cooperativeness, in the early stages of schizophrenia, if he has a good insight, he may be cooperative. Otherwise, he will be very uncooperative. Most of the times, the relatives will bring him to the clinic. The thinking, the thought process and the thought content, I give you a quick overview. All these thought processes are distorted. Suppose if I imagine that I am a schizophrenic, which I don't have, I will always be under constant threat that everywhere CCTV is monitoring me, all of them are watching me, and all my thoughts are read by others. That's called thought broadcasting. Thought broadcasting means na enna nenikirano adha TV la varudhu sir. TV e paakamulla TV serial la enna pathi varudhu sir. Thought insertion. He will say that somebody is inserting his thoughts into his mind. These are all thought disturbances. It will be very troublesome for the patient, so he will be confined to home. Then the next is perception. All of you know that you get hallucinations, delusions and paranoid ideas. That's why this fellow will wear always a cooling glass, because he doesn't want to see that person. Because somebody is watching me, so I want to avoid it. You cannot establish a rapport with him. He cannot maintain an eye-to-eye contact, so he always wears glasses. Hallucinations may be different, but commonly it's an auditory hallucination. It's not must that you should have an auditory hallucination. You can have visual hallucination, tactile hallucination, gustatory hallucination. Dr. Srinivas used to send me this sort of somatic delusions called as delusional parasitosis, where the patient feels that he has been invested with insects. Sir, poochi varudhu sir, the parang sir. Poochi poochi eduthu eduthu poduvom in clinic la. Our Dr. Srinivas, since he has got a huge practice, he jokingly used to say, ma poochi pudikira or udayam theatre pinnadi irukkaru, avarkitta po avar seriya pudichu uttruvaru poochi illam. Nothing to do with the dermatological problem, it's called delusional parasitosis. Emotion, mood, you know, in a schizophrenic, the mood will be sad sometimes, sometimes it will be inappropriate. Affect is blunt. Whatever you say, avade or maddu mari or jnani mari irupanga. Endha vidhamana or saranam irukku. Cognition, all of you know, orientation to time, place, person, sometimes it will be there, sometimes it not be there, memory may be impaired. Insight, that's what I said. In people with schizophrenia, insight will not be there. Many a times, many of them, yesterday I had a case, for 10 years he is living with his wife, he is a schizophrenic. His wife is refusing to come to the doctor and denying that he is a schizophrenic, he will not come. So I told him, over the phone he has been bugging me for more than 3 days. I said, please come, you come alone, I will help you. How I helped, I will tell you later. Next. Now the treatment has been completely changed thanks to Dr. Sarada Menon, who has instituted the mental health, who founded a schizophrenic lives, I mean completely changed. And from where she left, we have an organization called Schizophrenia Research Foundation in Annanagar. They are wonderful work they are doing. It's been recognized by WHO. They are doing wonderful research. Now, antipsychotics, many of you will know that about 50 years back we had only chlorpromazine, trifluperazine and haloperidol, which is popularly called as Serenace. Serenace is still a wonderful drug, but chlorpromazine and trifluperazine has gone to shelf, but still we do use it. Atypical antipsychotics like olanzapine, risperidone, aripiprazole, ziprasidone, all have completely changed the quality of life of the patient. Of course, there are side effects, like metabolic side effects will be there, but a patient's life is more important than a metabolic side effect, which can be always corrected with the help of a diabetic patient, with a diabetologist. A behavior, ECT, another stigma among the public as well as among the doctors is, do not subject him to electroconvulsive therapy. Dr. Dakshinamurthy knows, and he himself has given ECT, which has revolutionized the life of the individual. You know, sometimes the patient is very hostile, there is no other treatment which can give the relief only with ECT. You can calm him down, administer the medicines, slowly bring him back to normalcy. So we are not giving direct ECTs, it's only modified ECTs. Under the interval sodium and scholine, we give the ECTs. Now rehabilitation, that's what I said, Sarada Menon and Scarf, they have all rehabilitated him in the occasional units, like printing press, chalk making, candles, so that slowly they reintegrate them into the normal society. Next is depression. 6% of the population goes through depression in their lifetime. All of us go through sometimes. Whenever I come to speak to IMA Kodambakam, I go through a brief period of depression also during the course of preparation. Depression is going to be the leading cause of all non-communicable illness. Suicide is preventable. Once again, I'm happy that Dr. Lakshmi Vijay Kumar, one of our members, has started an organization 32 years back called Suicide Prevention Center, called as SNEHA. Round the clock with the volunteers, she has saved so many lives who are suicidal. Tamil Nadu has the second highest incident suicide across India next to Kerala. Now how will you diagnose depression? It's easy to remember the CGCAPS. S for sleep disturbance, insomnia, hypersomnia. I for irritability, G for guilt, E for eating disorders, excessive appetite or loss of appetite. I have a patient, whenever she feels depressed, she used to buy half a kg of Mysore Pak. Even one Mysore Pak, if you take from Gomati Shankar or whatever it is, Krishna sweets, you will feel nausea. But this lady takes half a kg at a time when she is depressed. That's her only coping style she has. Difficulty in concentration, anhedonia, that is loss of interest in pleasurable activities of daily life, like watching television, watching a movie or reading newspapers. Psychomotor agitation or retardation, sometimes they'll be restless, tossing up and down, or sometimes they'll be confined to one place. Last is suicide. The youngest suicide I have seen in my life is 10-year-old girl, which is very sad. I can never forget in my life, a girl's school in Ashok Nagar. Her father was treated for alcoholics, was still under my care, used to be a problem drinker, never allowed the children to study. So the quarterly marks came, the teacher said, why don't you bring your father and mother, because I am having a doubt, something going wrong with you, ask them to come. The moment she came home, she has got a provisional source, she went inside the godown, she poured kerosene, she lit fire, 10 years, without making any noise. Such a small child, I was seeing her from young age. She didn't even make a noise. But the smell got her mother to go and see the godown coming with the smoke. She banged open the door, saw the child, it's just like a charcoal. She brought it in the auto rickshaw only to certify death. I have lost one of our members who lost her husband in a road traffic accident. And on the 13th day when I was giving medicines and counseling, 13th day she went inside the theater, she is a gynecologist, she pushed scolding and she committed suicide. So sometimes carcinoma head of the pancreas or carcinoma pancreas presents only as depression, we have lost another member like that by suicide. So treatment antidepressants, we have age old tricyclic antidepressants like imipramine, prothiodine, doxepine. We still use it in a selected case. Now selective serotonin in reuptake inhibitors, the popular known as escitalopram, sertraline, mirtazapine, all have made a very good side effect profiles and they have changed the life so that the sedation, the quality of life is improved, anticholinergic side effects are minimal, they have to lead a normal life. See, ECT again, acutely suicidal, ECT is the drug of choice. Similarly, postpartum depression. The patient I have seen, one in Raju Hospital, where the patient was admitted, she threw the newborn through the window, thinking that somebody has interchanged the child. Now, such cases, because you have to lactate, so you have to give ECTs, with 3 or 4 ECTs, she will recover. Again, cognitive behavior therapy is also important along with medication. This is Dr. Raju, I was working in, late Raju used to say, your practice and veterinary practice are same. The veterinary pet will be briefed to the doctor only by the attender. Similarly, your patients, attenders only tell the complaints, and both of you give only veterinary dose. At that time, nobody knew. Stephen Stahl is one of the person. Is the right?
Center, sir. Center.
Okay. Stephen Stahl was meant a lot of research in psychopharmacology. These are all the neurotransmitters, dopamine, pleasure, reward, motivation, attention, mood, cognitive function, appetite, sex, aggression. These are all controlled by dopamine. Serotonin, obsession and compulsion, memory, norepinephrine, concentration, alertness, energy, vigilance. Norepinephrine again increases pain. That's why you use duloxetine. Lot of diabetologists, physicians use duloxetine. Wonderful drug called SNRI. So anxiety impulse. So these are all the drugs which have changed the quality of life. Now take home message. Psychiatric illness is treatable, ladies and gentlemen. No more stigma should be attached to any individual. Treat them with dignity is the one of the slogans of previous years of mental health. Suicide is again preventable. For a treating doctor, I have lost for 4 or 5 cases. It takes nearly for 2 weeks for you to recoup from the loss. We go through psychotherapy counseling with our own colleagues that I have lost. I have referred a patient working in Central Intelligence Bureau, was not making improvement. So I said, as Dr. Chandrasekhar used to say, refer. So I referred him to an MRCP trained psychiatrist. He said he went for 2 sessions. He came back, please treat me. I said, please stick on to that doctor. I have not made any improvement. But the same day, he parked his vehicle in Mambalam station and then jumped into the Rameshwaram, in front of Rameshwaram Express. It's very painful, very traumatic, because the treating doctor knows that it could be prevented, but sometimes something goes wrong. Newer molecules in psychopharmacology reduce the incidence of side effects to a greater extent. Awareness among other medical professionals should be encouraged about mental illness and their outcome. I remember when I joined VHS, one of the eminent neurosurgeons said, son said, when I was making rounds with my chief, that was the awareness among doctors. Even now, many doctors, children, they don't bring it to my clinic. Sir, ratri 12 manikku varingla, 1 manikku varingla, yaaru paakadha bodhu varingla, neenga vandha neenga yaarnu solladhinga, enga family friend nu solla. Na ungaloda family friend nu sollunga, ana doctor nu solladhinga. Primary care physician can initiate the treatment and refer to a specialist if need be. I know Dr. Chandrasekhar, Dr. Dakshinamurthy, senior practitioner, in those days have started their medicines with the thank God of imipramine and all. But the problem is, how long you have to give? The rule of the thumb is, any first diagnosis of a depression or a schizophrenia, give the drug for 6 months. If you are stuck with not improvement, then refer them to a specialist. Because sometimes எங்ககிட்ட வந்தா கூட அவ்வளோ ஹிஸ்ட்ரி சொல்ல மாட்டாங்க, பட் ஃபேமிலி டாக்டர்ஸ் நோ சோ மச் இன் டீடைல். ரீசென்ட்லி தக்ஷணாமூர்த்தி டோல்ட் மீ தட் மணி, அவனுக்கு ஃபைனான்ஷியல் ப்ராப்ளம்லாம் இல்லை, நிறைய சொத்து இருக்கு அவனுக்கு, அவன் 2 பொண்ணையும் மெடிக்கல் காலேஜ் படிக்க முடியும், எனக்கு ஒன்று எனக்கு நல்லா தெரியும், அவன் தைரியமாக நீ ட்ரீட் பண்ணு. ஸோ மச் ஆஃப் நாலேஜ் த ஃபேமிலி டாக்டர் நோஸ். ஸோ யூ கேன் இனிஷியேட் த ட்ரீட்மெண்ட் இன் தே யூகே தேவ் கண்டக்டட் அ ஸ்டடி. இஃப் யூ ஸ்டார்ட் ட்ரீட்மெண்ட் வித் ஆன்டி டிப்ரெஷன் வித் ப்ரைமரி கேர் ஃபிசிஷியன்ஸ், யூ கேன் ரெடியூஸ் த இன்சிடென்ஸ் ஆஃப் சூசைட். So primary care physicians were trained in psychiatry. Abrupt discontinuation of psychiatric medicine results in violent behavior, suicidal tendency. One of our patients was only on half a tablet of Trinicam 4. He had some palpitation. He was admitted 10 years back in Frontier Lifeline. They took a serious history. They said he was taking half a tablet. Then they said, stop, antipsychotics. Next day, the ECG, echo, monitor, everything went to the roof. They immediately packed off him to Raju Hospital. Is a psychiatric patient, go to psychiatric. Then when I went to sedate him, he just crossed.